The number four thing that he did was that he took away anxiety and depression. He took it away. We're immune from it. Now, how do I, as a Christian, I'm listing the things out that we're immune from. Then I'm going to say the same thing we've said before, and I'll keep saying it until you get it. Even after you get it, we're still going to keep saying it. Do you notice that you don't water a plant once and it grows forever? You keep watering it. Am I correct? Yeah, that's how you keep watering the word. You study, you heard it, I said it, you're excited, you go out there, somebody says something negative. Don't stop there, write it down. I'm immune from it. When the doctors leave you after they've talked to you, carry your book, start talking to your mind, debriefing your mind. Say, mind, the word of God says, I know he said that, I know he's good at what he does, but Jesus is better. You know, when the Bible says that Jesus was a man acquainted with grief, acquainted with sorrow, what does that mean? It means he understands and knows sickness to the point of discernment and diagnostics. He knows the sickness. He knows how he's doing you, like an African would say. He knows what's going on in your body. He's not aloof of what's going on. Bible says he's touched with the feelings of our infirmities. And that's why sometimes you find yourself, as a child of God, crying, weeping over something. It's the Holy Ghost inside of you who's just looking at you and saying, it ought not to be so. Hallelujah. It ought not to be like this. Number five thing is oppression and affliction. Bible says you shall be far from oppression and affliction. You shall be far from terror. It shall not come near you. Amen. We are not people that are afraid. That's why in the New Testament it says God hath not given you the spirit of fear. Amen. We're not supposed to be fearful. We're a people of boldness. Bible said that the righteous are as bold as a lion. Say, I'm bold. I'm very courageous. I'm not intimidated by anything. I'm not afraid of anything. I'm a child of God. And greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Amen. Number six. We're exempted from everything that is under the curse of the law. Everything there. Loss of wealth, loss of income. I don't know what is going to happen to me. The economy is so bad now. They fired me last week. I don't know what is going to happen. No, no, no. You're exempted from that place. See. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Be like Jesus. You know, we only think about Jesus when it comes to helping people with things we have, material things. Was that the only kind of person Jesus was? Jesus was a man of power. And that says that if we're like him, we should include both the good works and the power. Amen. You didn't ever see Jesus when, okay, the storms were going, they woke him up. He said, hey, you mean all of us are going to die? No, he was never like that. Hallelujah. How come we only copy, okay, Jesus fed the poor, he loved the poor, and all of that? You know why that is there and why some people just major on that? Because they have a form of godliness. They deny the power. They're not really Christians. Christianity without the power is not true. Something is missing. There's ignorance hidden somewhere. Hallelujah. A Christian is not supposed to commit suicide. It doesn't exist in the kingdom. You have to be in total unbelief to be there. Do you understand what I'm saying? If you know that tomorrow morning things are going to be better, would you commit suicide? No. It's because you don't see. The devil has, you know, created an environment around the brother or the sister, darkened their mind, and they have no hope. Without hope, there's nothing. And one of the things that people lose when they get into the gates, through the gates of hell, is hope. You know, faith is the substance of things hoped for, which means without hope, there is no faith.